top-of-the-line Ristamon group has been working lately. Organizations like Singer Vehicle Design, Icon and Gunther Works are assembling to a great degree top-of-the-line vehicles with sticker prices taking off well into the six-figure extent. The FJ company, as the name would recommend, manufactures some exceptionally cleaned and gently altered adaptations of the first Toyota Land Cruiser FJ. Costs differ contingent upon model and alternatives, however we figured out how to get a couple of days in the driver's seat of the new range topper, the signature display. This variation depends on the long-wheelbase FJ43 and begins at $200,000 before including any alternatives. There's a shorter wheelbase FJ40 accessible. Truly, that sounds like a foolish sum for an about 40-year-old Toyota, however a considerable measure of time and exertion goes into building these FJs. Look past the notable sheet metal and you'll discover warmed Recaro cowhide seats, warming and aerating and cooling, a reinforcement camera, and an Apple iPad in the middle support to control the radio. There are LED headlights and haze lights and a custom instrument bunch that includes computerized shows into the exemplary lodging. Mechanical overhauls are critical. Dissimilar to different models from the FJ company, the signature adaptation jettisoned the old Toyota inline-six for an advanced motor and transmission. Power originates from a Toyota 1GR4 4.0-liter V6 that can be found in different years of the 4Runner, Tacoma and Tundra. It's combined with a 5-speed manual. Four-wheel drive is standard, however you need to physically bolt the center points. Alternatives on the model incorporate a $2,000 move confine, $3,500 ARB air lockers, a $3,500 worn 8,274 winch end guard, $500 flip windows, a $700 cowhide wrapped directing wheel, a $400 jerrycan and a $250 greetings lift jack. Manager and Chief Greg Migliori, on a chill dim morning, I advance into the not really removed past where a 1981 Toyota Land Cruiser anticipates me. Clad in khaki straight out of British Armed Force controls and re-established to perfect condition, the Land Cruiser looks prepared to vanquish considerably more than the suburbs. This one is substantially more than a top-notch reconstruct. Or maybe, it's the formation of the FJ company, and our analyzer is the $200,000 signature display. It has everything from a cutting-edge powertrain, 240 horsepower 6, to extravagance outfit, Recaro seats, to the cool points of interest, similar to aluminum control handles. It's stunning, retro and bounty proficient rough terrain. I move in. It's frosty with the canvas top and back not protecting me from the Michigan winter. It takes two tries to begin. I snatch first at that point second riggings, make a left onto a surface road and get my course. The grasp is entirely simple. I push off my winter boots, in light of the fact that the pedals are near one another, yet something else, it's not an issue. The 5-speed tosses are long and fulfilling. The shifter resembles a hockey stick. It's so tall. Guiding is light and wallowy. All things considered, it's not hard to move. I bang and crash over the tight, broken asphalt, shaking my teeth and jarring me in my seat. I have a feeling that I'm driving a motorized mounted force charge. The 6 is skilled. I twist it out and have no issue getting up to speed. It's mid-morning and everybody's grinding away, which is disappointing since I'd like others to witness me driving this stunning, cool thing. Still chilly, I wrench up the warmer by sliding the lever on my right side. It's drafty. Beside the temperature, I like everything else about this lodge. Turn the handle to sign up the wipers. Push and draw different handles to work lights and washer liquids. Refined down to the essentials, this is an unadulterated driving knowledge. I don't miss the gigantic present-day advanced shows or voice summon frameworks. I drift once more into the parking garage. Pull the stopping brake, and feel commended. I decide on one of the FJ company's more affordable classic models, on the grounds that there's only a great deal of stuff on the signature display I needn't bother with. Something else, this is a fun toy that is consistent with the first Land Cruiser sold. Senior editor, Green, John Belt Snyder, Reese conveyed this monster to my home subsequent to lifting it up in Ann Arbor. It was at that point dull, and the streets were as yet covered after an exquisite winter storm. We bounced in the Land Cruiser, and Reese helped me aimlessly locate the different controls in the dimness of the lodge. I terminated it up, and we made tracks out to some frigid soil streets in the nation, our breath one of only a handful couple of things noticeable under the chilly delicate vest. for a great deal of the drive, I yakked to Reese about the Jeep CJ2A in which I figured out how to drive. This FJ helped me a great deal to remember that. The huge measurement however thin-rimmed controlling wheel helped me to remember that old willies, as did the long tosses of the shifter. The way this ricocheted over the trenches in the street felt well known. Not at all like the Jeep, however, I didn't need to twofold grasp this Toyota, which was a gift. The pedals are so near one another, and my duck boots in the obscurity made cumbersome work of them. Reese didn't giggle at me, however. This vehicle is a cool mix of old and new. The outline all around is a callback to more straightforward circumstances, however the more current underpinnings influence this Land Cruiser to feel more solid and dependable than a 4x4 fan as old as me, and with a significantly more seasoned plan, should feel. The expansion of a tablet as a kind of infotainment interface got a handle on a tad bit of place, yet it would have appeared to be much more bizarre were it mounted on the dash. For somebody with the cash, this would be a fun auto to have in their own Armada. I feel fortunate having had the opportunity to get in the driver's seat. My lone lament is that I neglected to sound the horn. I wager it sounds cool. Relate editor Reese counts, everything this FJ needs in present-day solace and comfort it compensates for and fascinate. Without a doubt, it's chilly, boisterous and about as agreeable as a wheelbarrow, yet it's so damn cool. The cutting-edge motor and brakes go far toward enhancing the driving background. It's not nerve-wracking like a ton of more seasoned autos can be. You never feel like you will be gotten out converging into movement or breaking into a crossing point. All things considered, the pre-creation display doesn't have ABS or footing control. Everything is moderate and ponder. The transmission may be present-day, yet the shifter is notchy and dubious. As John stated, you don't need to twofold grip, yet it makes a difference. The directing rack is enhanced over the production line 1. That is clearly a relative term, as there's huge amounts of slop and play on focus. Whatever. It's an old Land Cruiser. This stuff doesn't generally make a difference. The points of interest matter. All the switchgear, catches and handles are metal. The fuel top and mirrors are CNC machined aluminum. The shifter and four-wheel drive selector are these substantial metal pieces with fine calfskin boots. All the cowhide looks and feels exceptionally premium. That is the place all the additional cash goes. It's all unobtrusive changes. Everything looks genuinely stock, similar to an old FJ fitted for overlanding.